Hello students, in this video we will start the line integration, surface integration and volume integration in cylindrical coordinate system. For that we have to study what is the differential length vector and what is the differential surface vector and what is the differential volume in the cylindrical coordinate system. So we start with the differential length vector in the cylindrical coordinate system. If the parameter rho changes with the small value, then this change is indicated by d rho. Then this change in vector form, it will be indicated by d rho a rho. So d rho a rho corresponds to the change in rho direction. Now if phi changes, then we have to understand phi is an angle, right? If phi changes, let me see this diagram. This is the cross section, which is a circle of the cylindrical of the cylinder. Cylinder has a cross section of circle. Now initially point is present in the location shown in the figure, and it is making the angle phi with the x-axis. Now this point moves from another location, then angle changes with d phi. So we have to calculate the change in the arc, and we know there is a formula, angle is equal to arc upon radius. So arc will be equal to, from this formula, angle into radius. So the radius is rho and the angle is d phi. So this product is rho d phi. So we have to remember here that in the phi direction, the change in the dl vector is rho d phi, and the direction is obviously a phi. When we small change in the z direction, then it will be dz az, because it is a linear change. So this is the dl vector for the cylindrical coordinate system, and it is very very important for gate purpose. Now we talk about differential surface vector. Now for the differential surface vector, there can be three types of surface. First surface is rho is equal to constant surface, and it is the curved surface of the cylinder. It is the outermost curved surface of the cylinder which we observe. Like if this is a cylinder, then the outermost surface of the cylinder which is observed by us is the rho is equal to constant surface. I mean this surface which we can observe from the outer side. So this surface is rho is equal to constant surface, because at every point on this surface rho is constant. So if rho is constant, then obviously phi and z will vary for this surface, and we studied that phi variation is rho d phi and z variation is dz. So rho d phi dz, and what is the direction? So direction is the arrow vector, the perpendicular direction of the vector. So this vector, this is the direction of the ds vector. Now second surface we talk about. yes, correct. So the answer for ds vector is rho d phi dz, and direction is arrow. Second, phi is equal to constant surface. It is a semi-infinite plane. As we can observe in this figure, the blue colored plane is a phi is equal to constant plane, and it can extend up to semi-infinite wave. It cannot extend up to infinite wave. In the infinite wave, the angle phi will change. So we understood that phi is equal to constant surface is a semi-infinite plane. If phi is equal to constant, it means phi will not vary, and rho and z will vary. and the variation of rho is d rho, and the variation of z is dz. So the ds vector is d rho dz phi. Similarly, we can say z is equal to constant surface. If z is constant for any surface, then obviously rho and phi will vary. Now, the variation of rho is d rho, and the variation of phi is rho d phi, and direction is perpendicular direction, let it is az. So, rho d rho d phi az. It is the ds vector for z is equal to constant surface. Now, when we talk about the differential volume, then all the parameters will vary. All rho phi z will vary. So the differential volume dv, it is d rho into rho d phi into dz. Rho is the variation. Rho is the variation in rho direction, it is d rho. Phi in the phi direction, it is rho d phi. And z variation is dz. So the answer is rho d phi dz. Now after knowing dl vector, ds vector and dv, we can define the line integration. A line integration is integration a vector dot dl vector, where a is a vector quantity. We already know surface integration is a vector dot ds vector, where a is a vector quantity, and the volume integration is triple integration b dv, where b is a scalar quantity. So thank you, students.